But this loss of protection with the DOS-like structure is simply unacceptable for a general-purpose operating system today. On the other hand, the monolithic structure gives the protection that is so important. At the same time, what it strives to do is also it reduces the potential for performance loss by consolidating all the services in one big monolithic structure. That is, even though an application has to go from its address space into the operating system's address space in order to get some service, it is usually the case that the operating system has several components and they have to talk to one another in order to provide the service that an application wants. Think about the file system, for instance. You make a call to the file system to open a file, and the file system then may have to call the storage module in order to find out where exactly your file is residing, and it may have to contact the memory manager module to see where it wants to bring in a file that you want to open and see the contents of. So in this sense, there's a lot of interaction that's going to go on under the cover inside the operating system between components of the operating system in order to satisfy a single service call from an application. So this monolithic structure ensures that even though we have to go from an application into the operating system's address space, once you're inside the operating system's address space, then potential for performance loss is avoided by the consolidation of all the components that comprise the operating system. But what is lost in the monolithic structure? That is, the ability to customize the operating system service for different applications. This model of one size fits all, so far as system service is concerned, with the monolithic structure, shuts out the opportunity for customizing the operating system service for the needs of different applications. Now, you may wonder, why do we need to customize the operating system service for different applications? Why not one size fits all? Why is that an issue? If you look at a couple of examples, the need for customization will become fairly obvious. For example, interactive video games. The requirement of applications that are providing a video game experience for the user. Or consider another application which is computing all the prime numbers. You can immediately see that the operating system needs for these two classes of applications are perhaps very different. On the one hand, for this little kid who is playing his video game, the key determinant of a good operating system would be responsiveness. How quickly the operating system is responding to his nifty moves while he plays his video game. On the other hand, for the programmer that wrote this prime number computing application, the key determinant of performance is going to be sustained CPU time that's available for crunching his application.